This video is sponsored by Rewind Backups for Trello. More about them a little later in the video. If you clicked on this video, you're probably already using Trello for your project management needs, but are you getting the most out of this tool? Well, in this video, I want to show you five different things you should be thinking about so you can get the most out of Trello, whether you're managing a small business or an entire team, five different steps you should take so you can optimize your Trello setup. Hello everyone, Scott Friesen here at Simpletivity, helping you to get more done and enjoy less stress. And let's dive in with the first step, or the first thing I want you to think about. And that really is your lists or your different stages. At its core, Trello is based on the Kanban method, the method of moving cards or moving tasks through different stages. However, I find that far too many Trello users are not using it or optimizing Trello in such a way. In this particular example, you can see I have a fairly straightforward setup. I've got five different lists: ideas, tasks, in progress, pending, and complete. And the goal is to create cards on the left-hand side of the screen and move them over to the right-hand side. However, you want to be very specific as to what each of these stages represent, making sure that you don't have too many or too few for your needs. So, for example, many people ask me, Scott, why do I have a pending list, or sometimes I'll label this waiting for? I find this can actually be one of the most valuable lists in all of my Trello setups. Sometimes there can be a card which is simply out of your hands at the moment. Maybe you've ordered these books and there's nothing else you can do at this point in time until they arrive. Or maybe you're still waiting to hear back from these vendors. So I don't want to leave them in progress, because this might build up very, very lengthy and may not tell the entire story. This is a perfect opportunity to split or separate these lists so I can tell this information not only to myself, but to every member whom I'm collaborating with. So if you happen to have a list which is growing exponentially, that may be a clue for you to split that list into another list, making sure that you can come into Trello at any point in time and get a great snapshot view of what is going on. Now, in step number two, we want to add some more valuable information to our cards. You're already going to be familiar with adding things such as a due date or labels or members to your cards. These are essential aspects to get the most information out of the tasks and the things that you're managing here within your Trello board. But often something that is missing is how much time or how much effort is going to be applied to those cards, and how much time has been spent actually working on those cards as well. So in this case, we're going to make use of a power-up called Card Size by Screenful. Now, the good news is that this is a free power-up, so it will not cost you anything additional. So let's go in here and look at this card here. And let's say there's this new article. It's assigned to me, but I want to estimate how much effort it's going to take. Well, here under the power-ups header, you can see that there is the card size button. If I open this up, it gives me three different fields which I can start filling in. So maybe in this case, I'm going to say that this article is probably going to take me a total of 6 hours. Immediately, it's going to fill in the remaining slot here, meaning that there are 6 hours remaining. I'm just going to hit save here so you can see what this looks like on the card itself. So not only can I see it here within the card, but if I close the card, I can see that it has an estimated time of 6 hours. Now, if I come up here to the card size icon, I can click on settings and I can choose to add other things to the front of the card as well, including the amount of time spent or the amount of time remaining. But I'm going to leave those unchecked here just at the moment. Let's go ahead and add another one here. I'm going to add a size here to this one. Maybe this one is going to be only 3 hours. hours in case. I'm going to hit save here. And let's go back and maybe this redesign website, which is going to take an awful lot more time. I'm going to come down here to card size and I'm going to pick another number. One of the things that I like is that it will include some of the more recent sizes as well. So maybe you have some standardization or some common size durations. You can easily click them down below here. In this case, I'm going to say 12 and I'm going to hit save. So not only can I see the differences in the sizes between these cards, but card size also allows us to view this data in a few different ways. So I can see that I have assigned about 6 hours of work, but there are a total of 15 hours which are not assigned. I can also filter this by label or I can filter it by list. So if I want to see where the bulk of that load is. But let's go back into this first one where I said it was a size of 6, but maybe I've spent about 2 hours today on it. So I'm going to select 2. You can see right here, it's immediately going to show me how much is remaining. So it's going to calculate this data automatically as I adjust the amount of time spent on this particular project so I can keep track of it along the way. This is a fantastic way to get the most out of Trello and making sure that you're not over allocating or under allocating your staff along the way. Now, whether you choose to install the card size power-up or some other power-up, you may be fearful that those changes may alter your Trello boards. Or maybe you're a little worried about inviting new members to your boards and what they might do as a part of the editing process. Well, that's precisely why I use Rewind Backups for all of my Trello boards and why it's one of the top 3 most installed power-ups right now. If you want to back up all of your Trello data, if you want to go back in time in case you make a mistake, you can do so with Rewind Backups for Trello. And if you're not already using Rewind for your Trello boards, you can go to rewind.com/Scott-Friesen and get $50 when you subscribe on this page. Be sure to see the link in the description for more details. Now, the next step in getting the most out of your project management right here within Trello is by adding automation. How often have you told your team or maybe just told yourself that when I move something from this list to this list, I need to remember to add this label. I need to remember to add a due date. I need to remember to add myself or do something else along the way. And how often have you or some member of your team forgotten? Well, by making use of Trello automation, we can add a variety of rules to any Trello board, which is going to make your life so much easier. No more forgetting a certain step. No more forgetting to add a particular individual. Let's go back to my board here and show you a quick example. So let's say in my case, when I drag something into my task list, I want to remember to add the new project label. I want to remember to add a due date of, let's say, 3 days from now. I also want to remember to add myself to that particular project. Well, that's a lot of things which I could forget or I could waste an awful lot of time with. But with Trello automation, it is so much easier. Let's add a new card for this example here. So this is a completely new task. It's fresh. It's got nothing else on it. But when I drag it over into the task list, watch what happens. New project, due date 3 days from now, and I'm assigned to it, and I didn't do any of this manually. Maybe you have a certain step or a certain phase within your project where you need certain things to happen on a regular basis. Now, speaking of making our lives so much easier, the fourth step in our process is adding some quantitative data directly to our Trello board so we don't have to go looking for it or do some other type of manual count. Wouldn't it be nice if we could put some dashboard information directly here within our project management board? So here at the top of the screen, I've installed the dash card power-up, dashcards/track. And with this power-up, we can add a number of different customized or template information so we can keep track of what's going on, not only in this board, but perhaps across multiple boards. So in this case, maybe I want to take a look at some of the cards which have not been touched in a while. So in either case, I can choose to customize the options here, or I can just add it immediately to this board. So it's going to place it in the first list at the very top. But of course, I can drag this and move this wherever I want. Maybe I'll even want to create a separate list just for my tracking cards. In this case, it's telling me that I have 5 stale cards on this board. And yes, this is going to be dynamic. So as I edit or change things, this number is going to change as well. But it's more than just a number. If I click on this extra special card, you can see down below, it will tell me exactly which of those 5 cards are stale. And if I click on it, it will open up that card directly as well. So I can go in, take a look around, and maybe update that particular card. Now, if I don't like the way that this is displaying this information, no problem, I can edit this card as well. If I come down here and select Explore and Edit, I can take a look at the details. So for example, here it is looking at any card that was last modified earlier than 14 days ago. Well, maybe that's too much. Maybe I want to look at anything that hasn't been modified in 7 days or something like that. I can select Edit Filters and I can say, let's bring that down to 7 days and save it here. And then down below, it's going to show me which of those cards fall into that category. So you can be very, very specific. Keep in mind, you can add as many of these cards as you like. If I come back here to the Dash Cards button, I can select Customize, and now I can upload my own background. I can give it my own name and filter this information any way that I like. So this Dash Cards feature can really enhance the level of information and the amount of detail which is shown on any of your Trello boards. Now, the final step in our optimization process is to look at your Trello data in a different way. Although you may be very comfortable in working with your cards and your lists in this board view, keep in mind that Trello also has what they call a timeline view, and it's very much like a Gantt chart view, where we're seeing the exact same information that we saw in the board view, but perhaps in a more meaningful way. If we jump back to the board view, it can be difficult to see that this is actually spanning over a few different days, and this one is actually spanning over several weeks. But if we look at the timeline view, we can see that a lot more clearly. And the great thing is that we can work within this view as well. So maybe this create this onboarding letter is actually going to take a little bit longer than I thought. So I'm going to stretch it out here across the weekend into next week. If I need to adjust the time frame for this project, no problem. I can drag it and move it to maybe next week sometime. In addition, Trello gives us the ability to filter and view this information in a variety of different ways. So whether I want to break it down by member, or maybe I want to break it down by the different labels that we have, we can view that information here as well. And of course, we can click on any of these cards and start to work and look at the details within it as well. So for some of you, you may actually end up spending more time here within the timeline view even than the board view itself. And don't forget to back up all of your Trello data with Rewind. Go to rewind.com/Scott-Friesen to receive $50 when you subscribe. Now, if you found this video helpful, you might find the other content right here on the Simpletivity channel helpful as well. Thank you so much for watching, and remember, being productive does not need to be difficult. In fact, it's very simple.